Hello and welcome to the Feed My Sheep Foundation Bible Study video channel. This video will be a sort of like a revelation along with a teaching and also a Bible study, because we're going to definitely be in the Word. But it was something that the Holy Spirit laid on my heart to share on this video regarding how we are to treat one another in the kingdom, and then the consequences behind how we treat one another in the kingdom. And this is based on our readings from the book of Psalms and the different experience that David was having. He was having with Saul, and Saul, both of them were a part of the kingdom of God. Both of them were anointed people of God. And he was having a lot of trouble. David was having a lot of trouble out of Saul. However, even though he was being mean to him, chasing after him, following him everywhere, persecuting him, just being real evil toward him, David still would not be evil back toward this man, okay? So therefore, because he did what God wanted him to do, God was able to follow the agreement that was made, the covenant that was made between God and David, which was, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay." And how that's what happened with Saul in the end. He ended up dying of a horrible death in battle, as David had prophesied, okay? So, and then again, that's all in 1 Samuel, I think it was chapter 15 where that story is. And then it goes on from there and talks about, toward the end, what happened to Saul. Let me see, what was it? It's like at the end of the chapter, but I'm not going to go there with that. But today I'm just going to focus in on this video. We're going to stay focused on Matthew 7. And I'm going to read the whole chapter, but the emphasis is going to be on verses 7 through 12. Well, I'm going to actually read from verse 1 through 12, but the emphasis will be from the verses 7 through 12. Okay, so it starts off, "Judge not that you be not judged. For with what judgment you judge, you shall be judged, and with what measure you meet, it shall be measured to you again. Why behold thou the mote in thy brother's eye, but you consider not the beam that is in your own eye? Or how wilt thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mote out of your eye, and behold, you have a mote in your own eye that you haven't pulled out?" He's saying. And that person, Jesus Christ, is talking in this chapter 7 of Matthew, and he's saying, he called that person a hypocrite. You're a hypocrite. First cast the beam out your own eye, and then you can see clearly to cast the mote out of your brother's eye. And many times we may face that. And again, remember, we're talking about the kingdom, saints in the kingdom, okay? Because there is a difference, and I know a lot of people don't like to reflect on that, but that's where it's very important. It makes a difference, because that's why God, gave you the Holy Spirit and with discernment to be able to discern who is a part of the kingdom and who is not. Okay, and not that you should go around just being mean to, people that are not a part of the kingdom. No, that's not what God is saying. But there should be a brotherly love toward one another in the kingdom, because we're all one family. We're all one in Christ and a part of His Holy Spirit. So he says that verse 5, he calls that person a hypocrite that can't see their own faults, but they can only see other people's faults, and they only point out other people's faults, and they judge people by their faults instead of seeing them like God sees, because God knows everyone has faults, okay? And but he still has given gifts and talents. And he's still giving his Holy Spirit out to each and every one, that comes into his kingdom. And they still may have a fault, or they may still be struggling with some things until God has delivered them, or you may just have to carry the cross on with you while you're saved and a part of God's kingdom. You still have to get up and go forward in this journey. You know, so what Jesus Christ is saying right here is, you know, don't point out their faults. You know, look for the Spirit, you know, because that's what I look for when I see people. I look for the Spirit of the living God to see if they have been baptized into the kingdom of God or not. You know, that's very important to me. Because actually it lets you know whether you're talking to a demon spirit or a spirit, a heavenly spirit, an angelical spirit. And even though sometimes you can have an angelical spirited born person born again, and they may be saying things that don't sound spiritual, but they still are a spiritual being, okay? So, just wanted to point that out. So then I'm going to go ahead on here to verse 6. It says, give not that which is holy to dogs. Neither cast your pearls before swine, unless they trample them under their feet and turn again and tear you up. So he says, do not give that which is holy to dogs. Now remember, in the Word of God, in the Spirit, the Holy, you know, in the Spirit realm, when God speaks of the word dogs, he's referring to people outside of the kingdom, okay? So that goes right back up to what I just said about loving the brother and, you know, in the kingdom. And unfortunately, those that are outside the kingdom of God, you know, the word of God refers to them as being dogs, okay? And then he says right here to, you know, give not which is holy to the dog. So, you know, you can't give a pure, okay, you can't pray with the Holy Spirit over someone who does not believe in God, does not believe in Jesus Christ, does not think of God as being the creator. I mean, you can pray for that person, praying that they will come into the knowledge of the Holy Spirit, the true reality and knowledge of that the Lord will change their heart, help their heart. You know, we can pray all of those different things, but it's all about predestiny. You know, it's keeping it 100. It's all about who's destined and who is not. And you can spend a lifetime trying to change someone into the kingdom of God, and they may not even be destined. They may be from hell, you know, and they may not be, you know, ever destined for the kingdom of God. And I'm just telling the truth of what I read from the Holy Bible. I'm not going to tell something different on this channel other than what I see in the Word of God. And God specifically clearly points it out right here and all throughout His Word. And it's also in, let me see, where else did Jesus Christ say that? When He spoke to the woman about, when she was talking about her daughter being sick and she wanted her daughter to be healed. And he said, healing is for the children. It's the children's bread. The children of the kingdom's bread. It's for us, for us, saints of God. We're to be healed. We're not to be walking around here sick. And, you know, that's healing is for us, he said. And it's not for those that are outside of the kingdom. And then he talked to her about dogs and crumbs on the table and all of that. And basically referred to her as a dog because she was outside of the kingdom. She was not born again of the Holy Spirit. She had not accepted Christ Jesus as her Lord and Savior. So therefore, you know, that's not, God didn't look at her as being a child of God. And Jesus didn't look at her at that point in time either as being a child of God. But I think he wanted to just make that clear to us because I think sometimes, and yes, God created all men, male and female, he did, but he also has given us a new covenant for all that he created to come up under, and those who don't want to accept it, those who do not want to agree, and we've already did a video where we've learned that, you know, when Lucifer was kicked out of heaven, he took some people with him, okay, he took some saints that became angels with him, you know, so that's, you know, that's something that we definitely experienced that in the earth, dealing with those type of people. So, let's go ahead on. It says, verse 7, ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. So anything that you want to know about the Heavenly Father, all you got to do is ask Him. there of you whom, if his son asks bread, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks a fish, will he give him a serpent? So if you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good things to them that ask him? Okay? So that's in asking for what you want. You know, because David experienced that extremely. And he, so much that he was able to write a psalm about it. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Okay? So that was his experience with the Heavenly Father. And his experience with the Heavenly Father, and that he experienced getting what he wanted. So he said, verse 12, therefore all things whatsoever you would that men should do to you, do even to them, for this is the law of the prophets. Okay, so reciprocity is a part of the law that God made for the prophets, for heaven, for the country of heaven, for the heaven citizens, saints of God in the heavens, okay? That is, like I said, reciprocity. So he says, and this is what we're studying about, chapter 7, Matthew, verse 12, you know, whatever you want to be done to someone else, do it to you know, whatever you want done to yourself, if you're part of the kingdom, make sure you're doing that unto the people in the kingdom also, he's saying. Okay? And actually just do it unto everyone, anyone. But he's specifically stating as far as the kingdom, because he says it right here. This is the law of the prophets. And we know that everyone is not a prophet. Okay? Everyone is not in the kingdom. So they're, you know, they're not prophets. Because everyone in the kingdom of God is a prophet. Okay? Because the gift of prophecy, you know, it you prophesies through you. So, and you can prophesy, okay? He said, all gifts have been given unto us all. Okay, so you can prophesy, and this particular verse 12 was specifically meant for the kingdom of God, okay? For the heavenly beings, the celestial beings, okay? So in making that reference, I want to go and give some illustrations of individuals that experienced the reciprocity of God because they were doing what he stated should be done as a part of his will and his word. Okay, so one of the ones, we mentioned David, because of David, David and Saul was our first example. The experience that Saul continually mocked David and treated him very badly. Both of them were part of the kingdom, but even though they, you know, Saul treated him very bad, David still would not react to that. You know, he wouldn't do anything. What he did was he brought it before the throne of heaven. And we know that because of the different petitions and different prayers that we read about in the book of Psalms. Okay? So he left, he prayed to the Heavenly Father regarding that situation with him and Saul. And again, like I stated, the Lord intervened. And things happened just like the Lord said they would happen according to this verse. Because in the end, David prophesied that he was going to, you know, that Saul was going to die in battle, okay, fighting against the enemies, and he did. He died in battle. Okay, so that was our first example of reciprocity, because that's basically what verse 12 is saying. You know, what you're doing to the prophets, you're doing. takes your heart, okay? It's your heart. You have to believe from your heart and confess with your mouth is what the Lord says. So what God asks for in return of all that he gives you once you hear the word of God, what he's asking for you to do is to believe from your heart, okay? So he's asking for your heart. And when he asks for your heart, he's asking for your life. He's asking for your way. He's asking for your will. He's asking for you to give up everything and come into his kingdom and live the way he wanted. He predestined for you to live in the earth. And it may not necessarily be, you know, what you thought and what you had in mind, because, again, it's God's way of doing things, and it's not, you know, your way of doing things. So things will change for a person whenever they come into the kingdom. It will change extremely because, you know, you're born again from the heavens into the celestial being, or either if you've been already, if you've already came here from heaven and you're already a celestial being, you're being enlightened to be made aware that you are a celestial being, you know, you're part of the kingdom of God, and discovering your gifts and your talents that he's placed down inside of you, and then how to operate in them in the earth and use them to give him glory. Okay, so let me see if there's another example. We use God and man, Jesus Christ and his disciples, and the disciples. So it's all about basically, like we said in verse 12, it's a form of reciprocity. So God asks us, he asks for our heart because he asks for us to have faith in the word of God. Have faith in what we hear about Jesus Christ. Have faith in what we hear about salvation. And then we are given the benefit package of salvation, okay? And the things that come with salvation, he said that I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. That life is a life within your conscience, which actually reveals to you and lets you know whenever you are doing something that is not of God. Okay, it's a different kind of life from what people think it is. But it is a life of sanctification, in that the Holy Spirit sanctifies your conscience, and therefore, and the more you pray, and the more you draw closer to the Lord, the more you read His words, His word, the more you're going to experience that conviction, which is a convincing by the Holy Spirit of whatever it is that you may be doing is good or either bad, but you will get the conviction from within. Instead of without, because God placed his Holy Spirit inside of man in the New Covenant, in the New Testament. Whereas before, not that they didn't have, and they weren't a part of God, okay, but he created man from earth. So it was, they were much more different from God, because God is all spirit, Holy Spirit. Okay, so let me see if there's anything else we can talk about with this discussion. And just in making sure that we're getting a good understanding of it, because it is about doing unto others, or doing unto your brother, is what the word says, as you would have them do unto you, because it's the law of the prophets. Now this is what Jesus Christ is saying in his word, and what he was saying in chapter 7, and what verse was that? We just read that from, that's the 12th verse, and that's Matthew chapter 7, verse 12. And again, that is reciprocity, because that's what happens whenever there's an exchange. That's what happens with Christ Jesus and mankind. There is an exchange. We give God our heart, and he gives us his Holy Spirit, his kingdom. We become a part of his kingdom. And all the benefits that he has bestowed upon the kingdom family, we become a part of those benefits. Deliverance, healing, sanctification, protection, provision, prosperity, wealth, health, all of it, all good in the mighty name of Christ. Okay, so let me see if as I go looking through the notes to see if I have anything else. accord, and he will repay fury to his adversaries, recompense to his enemies, and to the islands he will repay recompense. Let's see how far we go down here. So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west and his glory from the rising of the sun. So when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him, because he is the Redeemer